Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, eco-innovation is rewriting the growth story of incredible India. Robust and ingenious green recovery solutions are absolutely necessary in the post-COVID scenario. It'll help in prioritizing climate, justice, safeguarding public health, and boosting investments in clean energy jobs. Over the past two decades, the world has become increasingly conscious of the pattern and efficiencies of resource usage. This has translated into efforts towards building a resource-efficient circular economy. Particularly, the plastic management is a challenge within this segment, and the management of multi-layered plastic is a bigger challenge. Domestic consumption is at 15 million tons against recycling capacity of a mere 2.35 million tons. Low house segregation and weak collection and transportation systems that support the segregation inhibit the recycling of plastic. High plastic recycling rates need to be reviewed in an environmentally sound manner. To safeguard the marine ecosystem and biodiversity, the Lakshadweep administration has prohibited the use of single-use plastic from Lakshadweep. Minicoy, the southernmost island of Lakshadweep, is therefore taking steps towards becoming a plastic waste-free island. This move has helped in remedying the adverse effect on coral reefs, hindered root growth of coconut trees, and improving rainwater circulation. The rich biocultural knowledge of the island ecosystem can revitalize and innovate sustainable human-nature relationships. They have the potential to become and serve as globally distributed hubs of innovation. Ladies and gentlemen, we have many lessons to learn from this. The government's Atal Innovation Mission is further fostering the culture of innovation and entrepreneurship in this country and amongst the youth of India. It will emerge as the tech garage of India, rolling out products and applications across sectors, including environment. The idea is to take the unique products being developed to their delivery levels with the private sector, much like Arogya Setu app, which is based on private-public partnership. A fast-paced innovation like Arogya Setu has helped in predicting more than 3,500 hotspots in the country at sub-post office levels, which has had a tremendous impact in India as far as contract tracing is concerned. And that is the key about COVID. How do we test? How do we do contact tracing? The population of India is getting younger by the day. The youth today is driving the digital innovation in the world. The young innovators must keep in mind three imperative lessons going forward. Innovation does not mean changing everything. While every innovation is a new thing, every new thing is not an innovation. Secondly, test the innovation again against ground deliverability. Success of an innovation is directly proportionate to the number of people it helps. Thirdly, believe in yourself. In a world that is increasingly unpredictable, resource-starved and volatile, we need an unconventional and unstructured approach towards innovation. I'm fascinated by how the Eco Grants Initiative has mobilized the youth towards innovative sustainable development. I would like to congratulate PVR Nest, Plan India and Center for Youth for creating such collaborative synergy for encouraging innovation in youth. It's heartening to hear about innovative green solution stories, be it the Smog Reducer and Energy Conserver project conceptualized by Green Earthlings to be implemented in Delhi, or the Jyotir Garmaya project Dehradun, an Android application for locating nearby dustbins and toilets. Each green solution is unique and shows promise for the future. All these green solutions that are focused towards restoring ecosystems and supporting sustainable food and farming will help both the people and the environment in thriving. I encourage the entrepreneurs to continue making waves with their thoughtful and life-changing innovations. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.